The steel industry is often referred to as the mother industry due to its fundamental role in supporting various other industrial sectors. In construction and infrastructure, steel is the primary material used in building skyscrapers, bridges, highways, railways, and airports. Steel structures provide strength, flexibility, and durability against earthquakes and heavy loads, while reinforced concrete also relies on steel as its primary reinforcement. In the transportation sector, steel is used in manufacturing vehicle frames and components, including cars, trucks, ships, airplanes, and trains. Railway tracks are made of high-quality steel that can withstand pressure and wear from heavy loads. Additionally, steel plays a crucial role in the manufacturing, energy, military defense, electronics, and agricultural industries. Without steel, many industries would struggle to develop, making it a key pillar of global economic and technological growth. Each sector utilizes different types of steel according to specific requirements. There are thousands of steel variants with unique characteristics, so selecting the right steel material is crucial to ensure that components function as intended. For example, the steel used for a cannon barrel differs significantly from the steel used for vehicle suspensions. Some specialized components, such as jet engine shafts, require ultra-high-grade steel that involves advanced technology in its production process. This demonstrates that, beyond mastering the steel industry, expertise in steel production technology is also essential. Downstream industries that manufacture finished products heavily rely on upstream industries, one of which is the steel industry. In this video, we will explore steel technology and delve into some basic metallurgy concepts. First, what exactly is steel? How does it differ from iron? The main component of steel is iron, but it is transformed into steel by adding carbon. Specifically, steel is an alloy of iron and carbon, with a carbon content ranging from 0.05% to 2.1% of its weight. This raises an interesting question. How can such a small amount of carbon make iron stronger, even though carbon itself is brittle and soft? When carbon is mixed into molten iron, it dissolves within the liquid. As the iron cools and solidifies, the carbon forms a solid solution within the iron structure. Under a microscope, pure iron consists of tiny grains called crystals. Zooming in further, these grains are actually metal crystals with different orientations. Within these crystals, iron atoms are arranged in a cubic structure with one atom at the center, known as a body-centered cubic structure. Iron with this crystal structure is called ferrite, which is relatively soft compared to steel. This crystal structure consists of multiple layers arranged uniformly, allowing them to slide past each other easily when iron is bent, compressed, or subjected to other forces. To strengthen iron, a mechanism is needed to prevent these crystal layers from shifting too easily. This is where carbon plays a crucial role in steel. Small carbon atoms fit between the iron atoms through a process called diffusion. If steel is heated to a temperature between 800 and 5950 degrees Celsius, known as the austenitic temperature, the spacing between iron atoms expands, forming a new structure called face-centered cubic, FCC, or austenite, where each face of the cube has an additional atom at its center. When carbon-containing steel is rapidly cooled, the carbon atoms do not have enough time to return to their original positions, and the iron atoms become trapped in a new structure called body-centered tetragonal, BCT. This structure is known as martensite, which is larger in size, acting as a barrier that hinders the movement of crystal layers. As a result, steel becomes significantly harder and stronger than iron. One of the unique properties of steel is its ability to be modified through heat treatment. This process includes several techniques such as hardening, tempering, annealing, and normalizing. A common example of heat treatment is hardening, where steel is heated to its austenitic temperature and then rapidly cooled. For instance, a blacksmith quenches a heated blade by immersing it in water or oil after it has been heated to a glowing red state. This process increases the hardness of the steel. The higher the carbon content in the steel, the harder it becomes. However, the trade-off is that the steel also becomes more brittle and prone to breaking. Therefore, selecting the appropriate type of steel must be based on its intended application. Carbon is the fundamental alloying element in steel. Steel composed only of iron and carbon is known as carbon steel. To enhance the properties of steel, additional alloying elements such as nickel, chromium, manganese, molybdenum, and copper are introduced. Each of these elements influences steel in different ways. Chromium, for instance, enhances steel's corrosion resistance. To produce stainless steel, the steel must contain at least 10.5% chromium. Rust on iron is the result of iron reacting with oxygen to form Fe2O3, which is brittle and porous, allowing corrosion to spread and gradually deteriorate the steel. However, in stainless steel, chromium reacts with oxygen more rapidly than iron, forming a thin but dense layer of chromium oxide, Cr2O3. This layer acts as a protective barrier, preventing the iron from coming into direct contact with air. Additionally, it possesses a self-healing property, meaning that if the layer is scratched, a new protective layer will immediately form to replace it. In conventional steel production, when the metal solidifies, some elements tend to cluster together, leading to uneven distribution. However, with crucible particle metallurgy, CPM technology, molten steel is atomized by spraying it through fine nozzles in an inert atmosphere. The steel solidifies into microscopic particles, each with a uniform composition. These fine particles are then heated just below their melting point and compressed into a solid form. The result is a steel block with a perfectly homogeneous alloy distribution, significantly enhancing its quality. Steel is a fundamental material that supports various industries. With advancements in technology, the steel industry is not only the backbone of infrastructure development, but also a crucial factor in modern industrial progress and national resilience.